I'm Object Blue. I'm a producer and a DJ.
I'm Natalia Podgórska, and I'm a visual artist. And I'm here as a mascot and to produce the visual piece of the piece. The piece is called Biome Vice.
Biome Vice.
Biome Vice. Well, I just really wanted to have to see burning forests. It's been haunting me. So I started making this, and you know, Rina was performing in Sonar, and I said, we need to make a new piece. We can't repeat the piece. So please, can we make sure it's going to be a burning forest? And she said, okay. And I just made sure that I picked vegetation that was responsive to real world. I picked Floridian vegetation, put in the piece, and that we really wanted to call the piece Florida, but we guess it was a bit ridiculous, so we just called it Biome, and then like Miami Vice, you know, that's the vibe. So I used to work as a florist for a long time in my life, and when I moved on to graphics, I honestly understand procedural graphic design as very similar to the way nature produces world. So nature and like procedural graphics are very similar to me. So that's why I love flowers, because they're pretty, but they are also very interesting and like not very silly if you look at them deeper. So that's why I always incorporate them in my work.
If I'm going to work with another artist, I want to respect their craft and skill and what they bring into the piece. So the easiest way to do this is with somebody who doesn't work in the same medium as I do. Because I find it very hard to write music with other people, because I spent a long time just being a bedroom producer, headphones, myself. I still don't really know how people write music together. Even though I've done a collaborative EP with TSVI and I really loved it, I consider that an anomaly. It's not really something that comes naturally to me. So working with a visual artist for me comes far more naturally than working with another musician. And I've always maintained a stance that I think you're a great artist. I trust your decision. You bring whatever you want to bring into the piece. She does her visual interpretation and I do mine. I also don't like to think about music as a vehicle for language or thought or visual art. I don't want it to be secondary to the visual art. I don't want it to be secondary to the contextualizing text. I want it to stand on its own. So for me, it's a little bit redundant or futile to make my music in a way that's like very accommodating of other mediums. You know, it's not a subtitle, it's its own and my favorite medium.
I don't want to build pieces that are only to be viewed in a special space, because I think that's very classist and that's very like a very small focused thing. I want everybody that comes here to be able to see it. The way it's built, it's just like a journey through an environment that I built. So you can just like, you know, see on the screen, you can see it on a stream online. You'll have the same experience as being here, I think.